Buckler. Trustee Brown.
Here.
Trustee Burgess.
Is there?
Trustee Young.
Here.
Supervisor Detmer.
Here.
Clerk's here.
We will stand and make the pledge flag.
To the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Jackie, come on. You get a church meeting. I'll just do it.
Anybody like? Anybody like any coffee?
They usually don't last pretty long, so wouldn't happen. For a cup of coffee, sure, 75 minutes. No, it's free.
All right, let's look at the minutes. Minutes of the scheduled meeting of December 20th. Did anybody have any questions or concerns on those minutes? Do you find any errors? Or Bobby getting so good at this, he doesn't do errors?
Bobby is getting great. Gonna do some, that's why he hurts so much. He gets that good body over there, and he's, all right.
All right, nobody has anything? Unless they're wanting to approve the minutes as written.
So moved.
By Maurice. Second? By James. Roll call vote, please.
Trustee Brown.
Yes.
Trustee Young.
Yes.
Supervisor Detmer.
Yes.
Okay, we have a public comment section. Anybody have any public comments they'd like to say? Seeing none? Supervisor report. General assistance, we have 10 intakes, 5 applications, 0 flat grants, 0 other aid, 13 pantry, 2 denied, 1 pending terminated. We spent a total of $2,110. And that was for the period of December 14th through January 10th. Just want to make a comment that our seniors' Valentine party, senior committee Valentine party is on February 14th. Have you got a full slate of that already? Have they all?
We've got quite a few.
Just still some old things?
No.
Okay, so we are recording this meeting, by the way, for everybody that is here. So if anybody knows of seniors that live in Monee Township, age 65 and over, we do have a Valentine's Day party, and it is free to seniors. And it will be here at the...
They have to call and make reservations.
Yeah, they have to call and make a reservation.
That is correct.
Thank you. I want to make announcement that our next newsletter is going to, all the articles are due on February 21st. So everybody please get their articles in by then, so we can get it out and published. And we usually want to get it published by around the 1st of March, so it's needed by then.
And Valentine's party is not being held here?
Yes.
What time is that?
Yeah.
And they serve a lunch. We have a lunch that serves. The senior committee picks out type of lunch. What are they serving this time?
Turkey, ham and cheese, bacon sandwich, and a bacon sandwich.
Then they always come in and they decorate, and they make it like look really cute and nice.
Are all welcome? Do you pay for it?
If you're a trustee, if you'd like to come, you can. We might do make your own 65, though, you will have to pay. No, you are one of our trustees.
What time is it?
Today.
It's about 1:00.
And seniors that have transportation problems, we make use of our dial line program, and we have them picked up and then brought here and then taken back. So I'll take it here. It's all for good charge. Okay, next item we have is clerk's report.
Well, the
a meeting scheduled for 2015. We'll publish in the record monitor, Monee.
Our meeting dates and how it is.
Record published at one time.
It was published in last Thursday, the 10th issue.
That's all that's required, is that it's published on us. We do it for the first of every year. We publish all our meeting dates and all our holidays when the township is closed. That's per law, I think, isn't it, that we do that?
That is meeting dates.
Meeting dates are per law.
So how on the university part?
By the monitor, of course.
But that's pre-Monee.
Pre-Monee one?
Right. A lot of subscribers and a lot of people.
Do they have a paper that published in the university?
Unfortunately.
We can also put it in the newsletter.
We put it.
Put it out newsletter, which will be distributed throughout the township, that PD on.
They call it in, they put it on the launch.
Because that's where you get on places where it ought not to go over the creek.
But you said, are you saying?
It's our newsletter itself.
Are you saying call and then let them know when the meeting, and they could, they put it up when we have a meeting before?
Well, we send them, I don't know if they're going to want to advertise our meetings.
A lot of people don't have cable. They don't have Comcast cable. It's only on Comcast.
We can send them a date of our meeting dates and let's just publish it, make a note to put in our newsletter too, so we'll be able to do it.
They also put it in the Southtown Star.
Southtown Star.
I didn't publish it in Southtown Star, but I can do that. Would just be one meeting date that was missed. Do I do that?
Sure.
Southtown Star?
Yes.
Well, unfortunately, the university part doesn't really have, there's a newsletter, and there are very few people in Monee that, they used to, years ago, put the Monee monitor out at some of the gas stations, and you could buy it in the university part.
You got the magazine that comes out through that. The people contact us, all the people who contact us support.
We've got no contact.
Instead of notification.
Yeah, that thing, and I think by the, for the following newsletter, like anything due like January 6th, to be put in like their February newsletter or maybe their March newsletter, so there's like a month or two time. Okay, Highway Commissioner's report, David?
Things are a little small, a little small.
Yay.
When I'm done, this is all, that's Sunday.
Yeah, I love it, David.
Wednesday. We also did some guardrail replacement. I put the old guardrail back on the bridge. And we replaced the guardrail on Pauling and Bridge on this at 57. The truck.
So you decided to put the rail back on Offner, is that it?
Yeah.
Say that just wasn't good enough with the.
Well, I just, but they're laying, in the back. So I figured I got to put it in and have to redo that one over here.
I feel better that you did.
So, everything else going on?
Yeah, that one is head over by the reservoir.
At the other side, it's set.
On the other side?
Yeah. Bridget makes a job here, it's out over. And the semi's going to get lost. And they back up the hill, I'm surprised they had a major accident there. And they get a big turn, and they run on top of the guardrail.
They're using the port bow, and they have to call.
I called one guy, we called one guy.
Are you compensating them for?
Oh, yeah, I did that a couple years ago. But usually there's nothing. I mean, that guy, he had a tow truck full of them. And then the police came, and I said to him, I said, I think he's over there, he's waiting. He said, well, driver doesn't have his bell, driver's license.
I say, our Will County Sheriff's Department, we are there also.
Oh, you don't look it up?
Oh.
and I got held up on call.
Okay, would you like to make a quick report? Usually, our sergeant, she will speak in public comments, but, you know, hey.
I know.
Rather I get to speak than not.
But I have some important information to bring here, so I want to make the meeting tonight.
Yeah, please.
The good news is, we have caught the burglar that's been just clobbering us out here. He claims that he's been working by himself. I don't know if that's the case, but that's what he said. So, not from this area, but he is in custody. And then, so that's good news. It doesn't mean to not be diligent still, you know. Just make sure you're still locking all your stuff up. You know, he's not the only one out there on the face of the earth that's breaking into homes, but, so that's that. And then Midnight's actually caught, with the help of investigations and others, got called with a suspicious vehicle and was stuck and ended up catching the people that had been stealing scrap metal from the industrial areas and stuff on this area. So that's a huge plus too. Hopefully that gives us a little relief out here. But like I said, you know, in the meantime, continue to, you know, do what you guys do and you know, call in anything out of the ordinary and weird and, you know, lock stuff up and just be on the lookout, so.
Great, well, that's good news.
Yeah, decided to come fight it.
Thank you.
Does anybody have any other questions or no? I can't really give any other information about the investigation that's going on right now, so.
Well, thank you very, very much.
Okay, thank you, Diane. Thanks for squeezing me in there.
Hey, assessor's report. Hey, attorney report.
Nothing to report. You've heard enough.
We've have been having some special hearings because we've, when somebody, people file petitions for offices, then people have a certain period of time to object to nominees for positions, and we have some objections, so then we had to scurry around and have some hearings, and we just finished our hearings tonight, so. Thank God, it's all, our part of it's over anyway, so people have, can go other places, but it's kind of, it's an interesting, it's very interesting. Looking at the plan commission, let's move into new business. The IRS mileage, they come out and said that 56.5 is the standard mileage. We vote on it every January, so I would like a motion to approve the 56.5 as the new mileage for this year unless they come up with a different mileage for us.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Brown.
Second.
By Mr. Kim. Roll call vote, please.
Trustee Young?
Yes.
Trustee Brown?
Yes.
Supervisor Dabney?
Yes. Our 2012 holiday report is on the table here. For Thanksgiving, we had like 95 applications, 94 were picked up. Christmas, we had 115 applications, 114 picked up. What was serviced is that the ages of 0 to 12, 134. Children receive 2 to 3 presents. In fact, most of them receive 3, and we had an outpouring of so many people giving us toys for that age group. It was just wonderful. And there was a lot of work getting sorted. For ages 13 to 18, we have 63, and each one of those received 1 gift. And then 19 and over, there were 141, and that includes mothers and fathers, and also many, many seniors, and they all each receive 1 gift. What we do with the seniors, because sometimes we afraid that that's the only gift they're going to get, is that we actually wrap those gifts. We do not necessarily wrap the gifts. We give, you know, the gifts to the parents, and that they can wrap their own, but when it comes to seniors, we do something a little bit more special for them, thinking they might be. Of those represented, there were 13 families in Monee, 12 in Park Forest, and 100 in University Park. We must say, to begin with, that we have a lot of volunteers, and we have some, the first biggest thank you, though, is to our assistant, Willa Simmons, We would not be able to run this massive giving program without her help. We, you know, we give, besides presents, we give, you know, food baskets, we have donated food, and so we ask people from, you know, all over the township to give food, but then all has to be sorted, and then all the toys and everything. We have come in here between November and December, it just looks like somebody just threw up their toys and food, it's just basically what it is. But we had so many nice volunteers, there was a Jada Franklin, who, Quan, is that her name, Quan Harrison?
Quan.
Yes, Hugh Lathan, Shirley Lathan, Jackie Mush, and Bridget Simmons. And would not be possible if we did not have the volunteers, and also the many, many, many donations that were. And then, of course, we had a lot of board members that stayed around to help Thanksgiving baskets, and we packed them, and David Deutsches with his crew went and picked up foods for us, they picked up toys for us, I mean, we just couldn't go on without David and the Irish Register without all the help they gave us too. So it was, Brian and Paul, who worked for him, they were just invaluable to come to this time of year. It's like a big family effort, you know, in the township, that we all work together and it gets done. But it is a big undertaking, so and there's, we have a list that will be published in our newsletter also of the different people and the types of donations, and so we will see this report in a little bit what we can guess from.
Make sure you kept your Willis pitch.
Yeah, and
I do have a comment. We've had a lot of calls of appreciation at the gifts that were given, and also the food, and they were just, everybody was just so appreciative. We've got thank you notes that I showed to the supervisor. And so I just want to thank you all for the call.
And over all the years I've been doing this, we won't have one person that called and complained in it like the gifts they got. Kind of like what, huh? Yeah, you know. But it's always a new one, but most of the time they are. They're just very, very appreciative. I'm going to go to old business, my dialogue program. I'm not going to get into anything this month because I'm really upset with them. Besides, we have a zero budget right now because we have not gotten any reports from them for July. So they owe us 6 months of reports, and they owe us 6 months to, in our kitty, of the area aging money. And I figure that it's not a true accounting, but if we take all the senior rides that we should have some matching money from, we should have around $11,000. And that's not going to be a true amount because then, you know, there's extra expenses they add in as we, you know, charge extra, you know, field costs and, you know, labor costs and things like that. But I would say we should at least have an extra $4,000 to $5,000 in there right now. So I sent them, had a bulletin, a nice note saying, please, you know, send this, you know, supervisor to life of accounting. And then I took that email and I forwarded it back to Bob Howard and to Pat Peters and to Teresa, who is in charge of their program, and then really got it. You know, I'm sorry, but mine, I said, we need a report. It is, you know, this has been 6 months. I said, my trustees are not happy. I said, I have no idea what we have in our, and I did my best to set zero because we've expended all our money because we're not getting reports back from you. So I've been assured that they're all working on it.
I am so glad to address that issue because it did come up for discussion last month.
Yeah.
You know, and I was going to ask you about that.
Yeah, no, I have been hounding them, but, you know, and I have actually told you, I had met with the RTA people, I met with the Little County transportation people who are working with the RTA grant and working with Washington Township. We contract with Washington Township for a dialogue program, which gives seniors free rides to, well, it's a donation. They can donate $2 for a ride to doctor's appointments and handicapped to school. years older, I believe, is the requirement for that. And it would cost us between each way $25 to $35, $40 a ride to do this. But, and we budgeted in our budget, and we do get some area aging money back from through a grant that Washington Township has with the area aging. But they changed people that were working with Washington Township, and unfortunately, the new person just hasn't quite got it all together yet, so we're behind in the report. They owe us some money, so I know our, you know, we're still okay, but now I'm trying to be a little mean and force these reports on them because it's making us look bad in our budget. So.
I'm going to always support this program, but just for clarification reasons, right now, we've got, according to their report, December 2012, we got $39 to rent, right?
No.
According to their report?
No. This is what it cost us for the month of December, $3,956.
Last month, we sent them for rent.
Yes.
And
but
so we already had money in there.
We have, yeah, we figured we had a couple thousand by our records, but we don't know.
Well, how much right now we're showing zero.
Our budget is showing zero, but we have an account with them, which is their, we call it a draw account. And their, our draw account, if they would put the area aging money that they have in there, should have at least $5,000, my guess. So I'm going to keep nagging them, and I'm going to be talking about Howard again, and seeing if we can set up a meeting with them.
So how much do you estimate we have in that account right now?
I'm just estimating about $4,000 or $5,000. I'm not covered January, put it that way.
Okay.
That's why I'm not sending the money.
And please don't think about supervisor, because the youth program is so efficient. $10,000 budget, $100.
Which is not true. We don't just
I'm trying to take my
money. We don't just jump back when we get to the budget.
I want the program to stay alive.
Well,
I want it to stay alive. I also want an accurate accounting of what we
I agree.
And what we got coming in, what we
need. Oh, I agree, and I've been pushing for it, but it's unfortunately when, you know, we're kind of at their mercy in there, you know.
And because how far are we into this? Over a year, right?
Two years.
So we pretty much went to our pilot program and our assessment program, so we said we're going to stay this for the ride. One of the issues we're trying to get reimbursed for the money that's owed to us. So I just understand.
And we have the carrot. We have the carrot out here because the RTA money is there. There was an RTA grant that was granted by Will County. Let's see, the problem is that Will County is in. You know, we kind of kept it within the township. You know, maybe that's a bad thing to say, but it's kind of, we just kind of been doing it the way we were. But Will County came in and they set up a transportation program and they said, okay, we will be the people that go to RTA now and make arrangements for the grant money because we're a large organization, we can probably do better. So they did. They went to RTA, they wrote this grant, we got the grant money that is sitting there. But it has nothing has come back. That was last April. And they came out with this big publicity stuff that says, yay, we got all this grant money, yay. Now, what's hurting us as a township is that we allow disabled rides, and our disabled rides are, we are paying the full cost for. We are not getting any reimbursement at all. The RTA money was supposed to reimburse us 50%. That they're waiting on getting the coalition agreement together. And I was, that's why I met with Nick over at the Will County Executive's Office last month. And they said, oh yes, we're going to get you that agreement by the December meeting. Well, we didn't get it by December meeting. And they said, but, you know, January, sure. Well, we still haven't got it by the January meeting. So I've got another call. I've got to call Nick again and find out what's going on because they've got to get the coalition agreement signed between the five or six townships that are all part of this group for the dial ride. Once we sign those, then they can get this to the RTA, and they're supposedly supposed to get some money, which I keep saying to them every time I talk to them, are we getting this money back retroactively on my handicap?
know, we appreciate you doing that again. I want the program to stay alive, I'm sure.
It has to stay alive. We, it's the only thing out here for our seniors that are underprivileged and, well, just the seniors that are here, which we have low income, and that they need.
The other concern that I have is that according to our budget, we have spent the entire $25,000.
Correct.
Okay, now, in order to meet, we don't send them anything this month. We're going to have a bill when we come back in February, but it's only going to be through January, half of January. So, but we don't have any money in this account, so are you going to make plans to transfer it into the local?
We don't have much in our contingency. We have to use.
We have money in our budget that we don't.
$2,000.
We have $20,000.
We have $20,000.
Okay.
We have $20,000 in our contingency fund. I think that we'll be able to transfer, and you can transfer within budget lines, 10% of your entire budget, so we're well within our, and we've not transferred any money to any line account yet.
Right, look at the front page, same, you was looking at the back, look at the back.
And there are other, you know, and push came to shove.
Get it down, babe.
There are.
Have you changed your mind?
No, that's in the budget, that's good. Okay, but overall supervisor, we think because our fiscal year ends.
Right, we're going, we're, and actually. We're doing a very good job. Last year, this time, like, you know, we were, I think we had gone a little bit, already had maybe a few, you know, changes, but we haven't had any.
And we put in your letter, email to whomever you need to send it to, or trustees, or admin.
I did that, didn't I? I took your names in vain. My board is very upset. Because I knew you would be, so I said that.
Thank you so much.
All right, no, it's a work in progress, unfortunately. Okay, next thing on my agenda is Creek Monee Award tickets. We did send the Creek Monee $1,200, I have a social service agreement, to help fund the Creek Monee Award, state award winning football team, you know, help them with their rings and some of their expenses for their award ceremony. So because of that, we are a platinum member or something like that, and they gave us some free tickets. Now, James already has his tickets, I'm sure that he has by now. You as a school board member probably get free tickets, right?
Maybe that one, did he want?
No, but what I would like to suggest, if you've got those tickets, I have to let them know tomorrow who would like to go. So I'm assuming that since everybody else has theirs, that maybe Bobby and I.
No, I want paid for them, I didn't have to send them to me.
But
I'm good, I'm good.
Would anybody recommend if Bobby and I would put our names down here and then we?
Well, then you can go.
No, I'm good.
Okay. So I will.
Bobby, can you, this is on the banquet.
You want to send one to Jackie, who's watching, because he is a senior trustee.
That's true. See, Jackie wants one too. You think Jackie would be interested in going?
Yes.
Yes, it's the Moyer Football Banquet, January 27th, 2 p.m. on Sunday.
Tenney Park Convention.
Tenney Park Convention Center. I have to let them know tomorrow, and that's why I brought these tonight to the meeting, to, they, we have to give them the names of who's going to be coming. No, thank you. Okay. Then I will, Bobby, is that day a good day for you, Sunday at 2 o'clock, January 27th?
I'll let you know by.
Tomorrow? All right. All right. If it is, then if not, then I'm going to, if you cannot make it, then we're going to let Will go. And I'll go. So we will, but we have two tickets, so.
Yeah, don't let it go.
One other thing, in reference to the weather that they sent, Jonathan Young has no relationship to me.
Okay.
There's no relationship. But what I'm concerned about is that I guess these are the names of the students who had not paid for the championship ring, and that we're supporting financially.
Where's that letter at?
Yeah.
Where'd you get that letter?
It was on the paper.
Okay.
Yeah. rain. But my concern is that these are the students, these are not all the students.
Just the Monee Township.
Well, that's not all the Monee Township.
No, every year.
You know?
I mean, it'd be so many. I should be.
I really don't know.
It'd be all.
I have no idea who those names are or why.
Well, yeah, I recognize the names. I recognize the names, but what I'm saying is that. They just, I guess they chose the ones that were not paid for, where are they anymore? They live in Monee Township.
This is all they sent us.
This is all they sent us, we have seen.
Because we sent them to other towns.
That's what, they were just trying to, what we, part of our social service agreement said that they went beyond, is that they put names on it, so they say eight players will be held by this. They, one of ours said, please tell us how you're going to spend your money. They could have just said, we are going to give eight players rings with your award money, or with your social service agreement money. But they chose to give names, and that's fine.
Now, you say you know someone?
Well, that's fine, but see, this is only eight of them.
But do you know?
And that's all that will be covered by $1,200.
How did these names come about?
I don't know.
Okay, do you know any of these?
Yeah, no, all those people, well, a couple of them.
Do they live in University Park?
Not that, I'm not certain about.
Okay, so what I think happened is, by group.
Maybe he just shows them at random.
No, I think he misunderstood, it says Monee Township.
Yeah.
He might have said Monee.
Monee, those are Monee children, probably, I recognize the name.
Well, no, I don't think so.
That's why I didn't know anybody from University Park from here.
I don't recognize.
That's my thing.
My concern is, how many are leaving out?
Other people have donated and are paying for the rest.
I'm not talking about that, Donna. My concern is that how many are still out there that are residents of Monee Township that cannot afford the rent? That's my question.
Oh, I'm sure it's all right.
Okay, I'm not, we're not.
What I'm saying is this, this does not mean that those other children are not getting rent.
That's not what I said.
Right.
That's not what I said. What I was concerned about is that this is only eight, and I understand all we sent them was $1,200.
That's right.
Okay, understand, we talked about that last time. But my concern is that how many of those kids that's on that football team that cannot afford a rent, that are Monee Township? That's what I want to know.
Well, Wes, you don't have to talk to the over and over district.
Huh?
That's something you'll have to talk to the school district about.
Yeah, I don't know.
We have given our.
I see what Bob did here, I see what he did. Like he said, we donated $1,200 from the township, okay, and thought Monee. Said, okay, here's eight kids, and he just divvied that up, said $1,200, take care of those eight kids.
And he was.
And I'm sure we, I'm almost positive we get quite a few kids in the township, which includes all of University Park for all practical purposes.
He just.
But I don't know what more we can do.
Well, you know, I.
But then you want some of the, you know, should we have, did we?
No, I'm not going to touch this, I'm not going to touch this. I mean, this is, you know, this, but my concern, again, my concern, I brought this up last month, is that we've got kids in Monee Township.
Yeah.
That's on that football team, Monee Township, meaning Monee, University Park, unincorporated park.
Yes, sir.
Now, if they cannot afford a ring, you know, I think our concern would be for them, just as well as those who are receiving the ring through our donation.
Well, there are many other people that are making donations, so I'm sure that all, everybody is covered. They're not going to not give a ring to some people on that team.
Well, no, so what they'll get is a box, and that was in the instruction to parents. As their names are called, they will receive a box.
Then I would say it behooves you as a parent to find out.
No, no. I don't know how this came about, how we sent the letter, who talked to the media for it.
Can you contact them?
Because what was our expectations?
Well, we only agreed to send $1,200.
Okay.
I tried to.
On behalf of Monee Township.
That's right, to help.
We didn't say how it was.
Right.
To help with the award ceremony.
I see what you're saying, should have had it with up a little bit, but we didn't make those decisions.
Those are not our decisions, though. And our decision is that we can only give that to the school district.
And I think he made a good gesture by saying, you think, you know, hey, Monee Township, there, again, let's look at the kid that lives in Monee, and let's divvy that money up towards the kids in Monee. I think that's what he did. So, and I see what you're saying, James, that hey, the township does include, you know, another municipality and part of another unincorporated area of our tour. So, So how do we remedy that?
I think the first step is to find out how many kids out there in university park, unincorporated park fours, is not going to receive a grant. That's the first thing. Then we just have to.
There is nothing that we can do to remedy this. I mean, it is up to Creed Monee to, they actually should not have, what we did when we sent it to them, we just said that, we have to give to Creed Monee as a 201U. We can suggest how they use our money. We can only make information to the district. We can suggest, and we did, we suggested to help subsidize the cost of championship rings and other costs associated with the awards program. And we did not state that, you know, it had to be for any particular people, and they made that decision to do that, and I'm not, I think it was a poor decision on their part to do that, by the way.
By Creed Monee?
By listing names that say this will help fund eight rings. Or this will help fund the cost of.
Again, in defense of the school district here, I thought he made a good gesture, saying, hey, this money's coming from Monee Township, and not really understanding that, hey, let's see what kids live in Monee, and let's show that we directed those funds towards those kids that are.
It's a typical misunderstanding that people don't understand the difference between Monee and Monee Township.
That happens.
That's what it is.
So how does it just?
I don't know, what is it that we want, though?
Well, I'd like to know the number.
Okay.
They live in Monee Township, out of University Park, and unincorporated. If these names are strictly Monee, and I don't recognize all of them as being Monee, but a couple of these kids on here, I don't know. Okay? If that's the case, I want to know the number in University Park and unincorporated park fours that's not going to receive a grant.
Okay.
And when you get that number,
we discussed that last night. I'm not disputing that, but I want to know the number.
Okay.
Okay? And then I'll work with you.
Okay, so you want me to take, is it okay with you, supervisor? I can take on that.
Please.
I'll talk to Bob on Monday.
Yeah, and maybe make them.
No, we gotta be right with it.
Today's the 13th.
Thursday. I'll talk to them tomorrow. I'll talk to them tomorrow. Holiday is Monday.
Yes.
I'll talk to them tomorrow, and I'll email you the supervisor as well.
Okay, thank you.
All right.
All right, let's move on to the merits of Monee football and cheer. We've been talking about, they came and said, if you'd like to help us out monetarily, and so we did ask them for a budget. And we have some people. Would you like to give them your names and introduce yourself?
Yeah, I'm Chad Simpson. I took over Monee Manager Football and Cheer this year as the president. Last year I was the football AD, which Chris Ramirez here is now the football AD. I've been involved with the football program. This is going on my fourth year. The people before us that were running as the president, his kids moved on. So I kind of took it over as my kids are in there. I got three kids in there. I got a boy playing football and two girls doing cheer in the program. The program's been around for a while. Prior to Courtney was the old president that I took over for. Prior to him taking over, there was a couple people over in the Green Gardens, Monee Township here that were running it. And they basically told him when he took it over that they put a lot of money of their own into the program just to keep the program going. And we're coming up on every 8 years we gotta get new helmets, every 2 years we gotta be reconditioned for safety reasons. It's part of state and also the league that we are in, which is football tackle. So every 2 years we go out and get them recertified, and then every 8 years we gotta get new helmets, which we're gonna have to start pricing out some new ones, because ones that we currently have, they no longer have, and they give us the price of $135 a pound. Also, we had a chair leading shower, a new one that we provide to the kids too. The only thing the kids really have to pay for are the jerseys, where they keep them, because their names are printed on the back of them. And they can reuse them year to year, as long as they fit. Like I said, I've been in the program for, this will be my fourth year now, and just taking it over and just going out. And I used to be involved in Monee baseball too.
So you know that we need baseball, right?
Yeah, I was involved in Monee baseball, and currently, at last year, I stepped away from Monee baseball for personal reasons, and I took over this program.
Now, this is a Maverick football, it's independent, it's not funded by, you're not just part of the village of Monee, you're just an independent group.
Independent.
Are you a 401(c)?
We're a 501.
501?
501(c)?
501.
I was wondering that it seems to be that the bulk of your money that's coming in is through your registration fees.
Yes. And like I said, we're actually in our league, we're the lowest registration, and that's to keep it affordable for the kids to come out and keep them coming back and playing. And hopefully with the Creek Warriors, as you're having success with the state championship, and all the schools are starting to recognize the Monee Mavericks more and more, because the prior people were not participating with the high school. As the feeder programs, a lot of them have been provided leads. So now we're communicating better with them. We're communicating with the schools too. Actually, the elementary school is allowing us to go in there and on conference nights to set up a table, and also they're in communication with us to do an assembly there. So the schools are starting to, you know, open up to us and talk to us, and we're having a lot more communication in prior years.
So you sent quite a few. It says you have 187 kids within your organization?
Yeah, with the volume, sure.
Right. And most of them are from Village Monee or Monee Township?
Correct. I think there's only like 10 that's outside of, a couple of them are from University Park that came over, and I believe there was a park for us to stay here this year. And then a couple from Piathon, I think there's a few that came from Exeter Park.
What's the cheer? Is it the cheerleading?
Cheerleading, yes. Yeah, they host their cheer competition every year for them too, that they do.
Now, do these helmets have the safety pad in to prevent concussions?
We're running our Rydell's helmets. And Rydell speeds, and the concussion, they got the air pockets and all that for tight fit and all that. And as we take the old ones out of service, because the time that they're allowed to be in the service, we go with the most safest support units. So all of them are not going to be with the concussion pads, but they all have the air pockets for it.
Is this organization a non-profit organization?
Yes, it's a non-profit.
Yep.
Any questions?
Chad, or is this Sensen?
Yes.
Okay.
First of all, I just want to commend you. It takes a lot of dedication, a lot of passion, a lot of patience, and all of the above to do something like that. Very there with the Maverick football down around for the first time. Myself was the first quarterback for the junior varsity. That was not great. That was a
$1,500, is that what you had, this is last year, I assume?
Yes.
Last year, so are you saying you had $1,500 in that account, or in that line item, under your budget, which you listed in as expense, right?
That would,
for the account.
Right, for the account that
Pay for their county expense.
The county expense, which, they hired Paltry to do.
Okay.
What happened was,
I'm not looking so much at, but what the bad line item is.
Okay.
So, just trying to take you across from left to right, so I can understand it. Okay, you have $1,500 that was put aside for that account, is that correct?
Yes.
And it's going across income, and then you go across all the way to this actual expense, so I'm assuming that you actually paid about that $1,500 to be budgeted, you paid $800 out of that, what I'm looking at here?
Yes, I believe, so, okay, the expense was $800, yeah.
So those are, anything that's under the actual, or the actual expenses that you spent last year?
Okay, true. And then it says, going across, and it says profit, $800 in the balance, which $800, you have the negative currencies around, which means minus, negative. So, I'm a little confused on that, it kind of goes along with the whole process, so I'm just a little confused, and I'm not putting you on the spot, but I think, right, I don't know, what member?
No, I know what you're saying, because I have some of the same questions, because normally
Budget, that's all, you know.
I think what they're saying, it didn't make sense, because you've got $1,500 within your budget, you actually spent $800, so that actually left $700 that was unexpended, but, you know.
But then it's a negative $800.
Right, and that's
So, that's consistent kind of throughout, so, that's, there again, that's, you know, it's an effort here, but I just challenge you to go look at that, clean it up,
Right.
Come to an organization, like the township here, people, they scrutinize that, you know, they're saying that, you know, have good hands on your budget, that we don't need money to the organization, what are you gonna do with that money? I see the effort, I understand what you're doing, again, I commend you, but it just kind of, especially with the financial guy, so to speak, it just kind of, you know, that kind of stood out.
Right,
No, I understand. That's all right.
Yeah, it's just the pluses and minuses, like, if I was doing it too, because I kind of went through and kept writing it over, because I'm like thinking, well, if you take your expense, and then, you know, the income, I'm assuming is what you actually made
Right.
off an event, like on, you know, like on a taco night, the expense was $678, but your income was $1,575, so then, you know, the difference was actually your profit on that, so.
But you just want to be careful, because again, you never know, it happens all the time, it's appropriate to funds, organizations, leaders, funds, the next thing you know, the newspaper, they look like
Right.
the education, because you don't
Right.
organization. So, I just challenge you to go back to your team and look at the way that things are documented here, probably is another way, everything is documented fine somewhere else, but this is what you have given us today, here's some noticeable issues.
Yeah, I think you need to go back to your accountant and say, hey, you know, come on, let's do a better spreadsheet here, because this is, you know, it really doesn't make much sense when you're looking at it, trying to figure out what your actual bottom line is. So I was actually just adding up your expenses and your income, and your income came to $56,959, and your expenses were $53,366, so right now, you should have approximately $3,500 left in your bank account, is that something, what you kind of think you have?
Yes.
Okay.
And we had a meeting on Tuesday, and as of Tuesday, we had a balance of $3,367.34.
Were all bills paid?
The only bill that's outstanding was right out, for all the helmets and equipment and some of the stuff that we had purchased. services, and we are on a payment plan with them of $500 a month, and the only, we got the money to pay them off, but we also have our Ivy League dues coming up, and insurance, and then also we got to pay for storage for the equipment.
So you got more than one deal out there, so you consolidate the bill versus the money you have in that account, how much would you have now?
We would, as of last year, we owe right off $1,300, and...
So roughly, how much would you have left?
Storage, we pay on a monthly thing, that's $111, so, with minusing out the $1,300 that we owe right now, we would have $2,067.
Plus some deals still out there.
The only bill that we pay every month would be the storage, and then when we, and I believe in 4 months from now is when we pay for the leak fee of being in there, and that's when our registration money comes in, so.
So you're right on target, basically, where you should be, which is not, you know, too much in the black, but, you know, a little bit. What we have done with the baseball association is that we gave them a donation, I believe, of $550, is that right, Willa? Because I believe we paid for...
Banner.
I'm sorry, what?
Banner.
Oh, yeah, it was like a banner, and then there was something else, but I think the total was $550. So my suggestion would be that we don't want to play favors between football and baseball, so I would suggest that what we do is that, somebody make a motion to donate $550 to the Mavericks, football league.
I make a motion to social services.
Under social services, I'm sorry.
How many kids do we have in baseball? You know, how many kids? There's 187 kids in this world.
Usually all the kids from baseball,
So majority of them, baseball?
Yeah, a lot of them play both, yes.
And that's the whole group, you know, junior varsity, PA, and all of that.
Yes.
It's not...
It ranges from 5 to 14, as long as A&M and high school, so it goes through junior high, 8th grade.
Do we know how much we donated last year, man?
None, this is the first year we've been asked.
So I'd make a motion that we donate $550 under our social program to the, is it fair to say, Monee Mavericks football organization?
Yes.
That is under Monee, even though Monee per se is not over center.
It's called Maverick Football Cheer.
Monee, can we throw Monee in there?
What's the actual name of your organization, though?
Monee Maverick Football Cheer.
Monee Maverick, okay.
That's only representing the towns because the other, you know, league that totally know what happened.
Monee Maverick, social worker, Monee Maverick.
You got a motion out there?
Is there a second, please?
But you don't want to get a discussion of increase.
I think we put the motion out.
Is there a second? I
heard him say that a lot of kids in baseball go over to football. And I understand that I'm not one of the favorites, but football is more of a, it's more of a physical strain.
It's more toward, more defensive.
Contact.
A whole line yards.
Sport. Okay, and I am in favor of giving them a donation. But I think $15, not a small donation, such as $7.
So you're making, you would like to ask to amend the motion to be $750?
I think we have to withdraw our motion.
I will withdraw my second, if you'd like to withdraw your motion and start over.
Yes, I will. So now I make a motion to donate.
What's your agreement to?
$750 under our bill, under our social service agreement with the Monee Maverick Football Organization. To give them $750.
A second.
Second. Move in second, any further discussion? Roll call vote, please.
Trustee Brown? Trustee Brown?
Okay, hold on a second. Can I discuss, can I make a comment that doesn't have anything to do with our township, but is relevant to?
Absolutely.
You do have a motion there for it.
So you're gonna make it down to you.
Trustee Brown?
Yes.
Trustee Young?
Yes.
Supervisor Deborah?
Yes, and before we make this comment, the way we do this is that we'll make a social service agreement, and she has her email address, she can email it to you, and then you would have to sign it and then send it back to us, and then I'll sign it at that, which time then we will produce a check, and the check then would be signed at this next board meeting. Well, actually, I'll sign it, and then we'll probably send it to you, because it'll be approved here.
Okay.
When if you have produced, indicated the nonprofit, Title 1C, produce some documents, we can archive them all.
Yeah, if you, yeah, the copy of your Title 1C.
Okay.
All right.
Okay. All right.
Your comment?
Okay, when I ran for this position, I did say that I would donate my check to the veteran of the community in every capacity I could. So, and I'm putting ownership on you, Mr. Simpson. If you contact me, and I'll just match the $750, so that would be $1,500.
Okay.
Wow.
I won't get on you about the people in it.
You won't tell me.
I'm passionate about kids, if anyone knows, you know, I'm passionate about you and kids. There's a process work, because I don't know my kids to go through what my kids went through. So anything to mitigate that.
Okay.
Thank you. You can get my phone number, I can talk online on this.
Okay.
If you want to, can I give them this one now? Write it down. Okay.
Yeah, one comment.
And I have a card, my phone number is different on it, or I change on it.
Okay, well, let's move along. My training, actually, everybody concluded their already training last year, so we probably can take this off our agenda now, I think, Willa. Okay, so we are good to go. I don't think, Joe, I think that was the one-time thing, right? As long as we have new board members or something, then we have to put it back on for new board members.
Check that, I suppose, if you want to do it.
But I thought that was like, it's not like yearly we have to do a FOIA for those that are working with the FOIA.
I don't think so. I don't think you do, but I'll check it.
All right, let's move into youth commission.
early, so to speak, you know, but yet and all, it's still a good night. People hate the league. 9 o'clock, you gotta kick them out, and, but overall, it's good. I think we have about 40 people this past Sunday, thereabout. Again, it's great to work. It goes out in our leaflet. I don't know, the park fours, have you heard of our youth program? Okay, you have.
I have.
Okay, so I'm gonna challenge you guys, it's great for on your side of the fence over there. So, but overall, it's going pretty well. Really well. Is there, oh, I did have, I wasn't here last meeting, and I don't think trustee Young had an opportunity to get it in. But one of the issues that we are being faced with is people outside of the township wanting to participate. And I'm like, how do we handle that? I don't want to keep people out and away, because, you know, they're saying that this is the only thing around here. As far as you can go to 394, all the way back this way, I-57 and beyond, that gives families an opportunity to be with their kids and do things. So, what do we do? Do we charge that extra, you know, should I get with my committee? Should I talk about it and bring it back to the board, or what do we do?
This is a township sponsor.
It is a township sponsor.
Township's money, and so we cannot really open it up, per se, to the public free.
No, I'm not saying it at all.
Is it something, Joe?
It's not even free for the township.
We don't think a $5 fee, that's it.
It's a minimum.
That is not anything.
I mean, within reasons, I don't want people coming from all over the world, but I think we manage.
Well, the biggest problem we have is this. We have 3 people right now that are volunteering their time. That's it, you and your family.
Right.
And we haven't yet, we don't have any other volunteers that we've sent over through our vetting program.
Yeah, I see one out there. Maybe two.
But what I'm also saying is that we have a limited number of chaperones.
Sure.
We have to be very careful about the number of people that we want to bring in that are beyond Monee Township with the limited number of volunteers that we have, because this is a volunteer program of people that are chaperoning.
And again, we don't have to stop it tonight, but, you know, you can give me the issues that you see, and then I can come back with a remedy and say here, but I just want.
That's the biggest one. I mean, it's just the volunteers. We just don't, you know, we need to build a bigger pool of volunteers, and then I think then we'd have to talk about, Joe, about.
I could see some questions that I could get better before. I think about it a little bit more, but.
We can talk about it next month, but let's kind of ruminate about it.
Why don't we do this? We know there's a interest. Okay. And one of just the reasons that Mar was mentioned. So why don't we brainstorm it? You know, we'll take it to the committee, brainstorm it, they give you some time to think about it. Jackie, if Deborah's not here, I'm sure they probably have some concerns. And then give Joe some time to think about it and to brainstorm it. And then, you know, maybe we can put it on the agenda for next month.
The other thing we have to think about too is that there is an election coming up, and whether or not, you know, we do not come up handed and are not reelected, then there's the problem of, you know, will the next board continue, because right now we've got, you know, some very good volunteers in the next board.
What are your thoughts about that?
Right.
Well, we're still Monee Township residents, okay? And we still can advocate for that program as citizens. We can still attend these meetings.
Sure.
And we can still volunteer our time. So.
No, yeah, but that's why we carry this out until the board changed over when May. And I think I carried this out until then, so I kind of strategized that, because, yeah, you don't know what happened. And I'm hoping it carries on if I'm on the board or not, but, I mean, the senior program, there was a lot of concerns when we came on board with that program to continue on, and I promised, you know, people that I have no way
one of the things we need to discuss, and I was thinking about this, is that that contract we got with the state includes that swimming pool.
Yeah.
Okay, but you know, we're gonna have a lifeguard last Sunday. We're not gonna have a lifeguard.
We may not.
We may not.
Right.
Okay.
That was the issue. I had them document that on the contract. There's some issues that went forth last week. But, you know, we can, as far as, you get into the cost effective.
No, I'm talking about the commitment that we have with the state.
You know, things happen, they far things happen, and they were very apologetic.
Okay. As long as it's not.
No, it's not. No, they were very apologetic. I said with their director, I said with them, I had a meeting, an hour and a half talking about this, and they were really challenging to come to me to tell me this.
We know a lot of residents asked about this, and they weren't going this one.
Sure.
We couldn't.
And I didn't know how to get it out. I mean, it was kind of the last bit when they told me. And I didn't know, I said, the only way I can get it out is just, don't get it out, but just let people know.
But we're clear, they're not going, I mean, swimming pool is gonna be the swimming pool, they're gonna get a lifeguard pool.
This week?
Well, they said not this week, but.
Oh, we don't.
Third week.
There was an issue with the lifeguard, so.
That was three of the pools closed?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's closed.
Well, but they're working on solving it.
Yes. Oh, absolutely.
Okay. My question, let's go back to the thing, the billing. As mentioned on your budget, we have only $10,000 on a budget line for the news committee. We show that we have spent in a year $100. Now, that is because DSU has not billed us. And we have asked them to bill us, but we have not had a billing since. We voluntarily paid in March, because we didn't want to carry, you know, a bill into this next year, what we owed last year. So we figured out what it was and sent them money. Should we do that now?
Okay, I mean, right at this point, I think we should have moved forward. Okay, but next contract, we said that in our contract, 30 days, right? The bill, I think it said 30 days, something like that. But there's no ramifications, there's no consequences. So next time we say, hey, people, if you don't bill us within 30 days, we have a right to not pay you.
Yeah, we have a right to, you know.
It's a hotel. But I talked to the director, like director, assistant supervisor, the whole nine yards. I paid my case. I'm like, what more can I do? You know, you guys know what to do. I don't know.
I mean, I don't know why. I mean, I really kind of, I mean, this DSU was also taxpayers' dollars besides their registration and that.
Sure.
But the thing is that we're using their facilities free at this point in time because they will bill us. We keep asking, please bill us, you know, when they have billed. And, but I think, well, please do, but, you know, we'll figure out what we, you know, the dates that we had last spring, and then what we've used in the fall, and what so far,
just send them a check.
And then we'll send them, you know, we'll get a check ready for them that we'll sign for at this next meeting. And
CC our attorney, and make sure that they see that.
Right, that we are voluntarily going to do this, even though we have not received a bill from you, as per contract that we're supposed to be billed within 30 days, whatever.
Per contract, yeah.
Because we're just, I mean, it's crazy. And the problem is, I don't want us to get into like we did last year, where when our fiscal year ends on March 31st, we have to have every bill that is due by March 31st paid. Otherwise, if we don't pay it out of this year's monies, then unfortunately, it would come out of next year's budget line, and he doesn't want that.
Right, I agree.
We do want to use our money for the fiscal year, so that's what we need to do on that. Okay, anything else?
Nothing, that's all I have for you. I don't have anything to report before it rings.
Okay. All right, then let's move into audit of accounts. We'll start with you.
Second.
I moved to second. A roll call vote, please.
Okay,
Graff?
Yes.
Keon?
Yes.
Supervisor Dexter?
Yes, could you give that to Bob, please? All right, any board comments?
I just have one comment, and I don't think everybody has the township perspective for this one. I'm sure you have.
I can't look at it.
And this is something, again, if we move forward, if the majority of us here for the next election, I thought here's a good opportunity to promote the township at minimum cost. I saw one township doing this, but they had something what they call touch a truck. So I'm sure we need that, okay, touch a truck. Yeah, it's a way to engage the communities, municipalities. It's a good size event, so read the story. And if this is something that we can do, we need some land, right? I volunteer the parcel of land that I have if we look to do it this fall. But this is something, just look at.
We will read this article, do our homework.
Just reading, but I'm just saying, I thought about dating and all this vehicle, but this was a good article. It was a good article.
All right, well, we.
So I challenge you to read the article and then come back with your findings. I get my wheels turning all the time.
All right, anybody else?
Well, this is the first board meeting of the year, so I wish all of you a happy, prosperous, and peaceful 2013.
Thank you, I like the peaceful and the prosperous. The healthy, I like the healthy part, you're right. All right, same with everybody else. Then is there a motion to adjourn?
So.
Second?
Second.
Roll call vote, please.
Trustee Connor?
Yes.
Trustee Young?
Yes.
Supervisor Dexter?